Assalamualaikum, I am Maryam Baloch, holding roll number 18BM31 and my project partner Soap Nawaz, roll number 18BM111. We have designed solar charger in which we have used four main components. The first component is solar panels and the second most important component is solar charge controller and the third component is DC motor we use as a load. And the fourth component is our 7-volt rechargeable battery. I am giving you some quick and basic overview about the components we have been used in this project, that how they work. So our first and main component, that is solar panel. Let's begin with how it works. Solar panel made out of silicon wafers and are semiconductor material. They work by allowing photons or particles of light to knock electrons free from atoms, which causes to generate electric field and that causes to generate a flow of electricity. Solar panel comprise many smaller units called photovoltaic cells. Photovoltaic simply converts sunlight into electricity. Here we use solar panels. Each solar panels of 6.5 volt. We connect them in parallel, so overall they give us 6.5 volts. We can check it by using voltmeter or multimeter. Our second most important component is solar charge controller, also known as solar regulator, because it regulates voltage and current. It is essentially a solar battery charger connected between battery and solar panels. Its job is to regulate the battery charging process to ensure the battery is charged correctly or, more importantly, not overcharged. It automatically switches off when battery is fully charged to protect it from damage. The solar charge controller we use, it works up to 12 to 24 volts and maximum on 10 amperes, which is a huge amount of current. You can see here is 6 holes consist of 3 pairs for the connection of panel, battery and load. The first pair, which is for the connection of panel, there we will connect the positive and negative terminal of panel. Second pair is for battery, we will connect positive and negative terminal of battery here. And the third one pair is for the load. We will connect the positive of the solar charger panel terminal with the positive of the load and the negative of the charger with the negative of the load. Second important thing is its display. Here it will show the overall voltages and the voltages of battery in decimal numbers. Our third component is a rechargeable battery. It is of 7 volts and its cycle use is 7.2 to 7.5 volts and it will give 1 ampere current or less than 1.35 amperes. Our last component is 12 volt DC water motor, which we use here as a load. You can use LEDs, light, fan or any other simple DC motor as a load. So I have given you some basic information about all the components we have used in this project. Now Soap, my project partner Soap, will explain you about the connection we have done.
Here we have two panels, panel 1 and panel 2, and we connect both panels in parallel because we want current to add. If we want to voltage to add, so you must connect two panels in series. So here I take first panel's positive and connect it to the second panel's positive, and I take first panel's negative and connect it to the second panel's negative. We want current, so we want to add current in parallel form. If you want to add voltage, so you can add in series. So here I have two wires, pair of wires. One is positive and one is negative. Connected positive of our panels. And then take negative of controller and it connected panels negative. After that, we have a battery. My partner also told you earlier. And we also connect it with positive and negative of terminals, controller terminals. So here is a positive. I connect it. And the negative. I take a DC motor for the connection of positive and negative with the controller. So here first I take the wire of positive of controller and connect it with the positive terminal of motor. Then I take a negative wire of controller and connect it with the negative terminal of the motor. Then here you can see some values are present in the display. So first of all, I started initially. After that is a 12.6. This is the minimum voltage. At this voltage, our load is easily work through the battery. 10.7. This is the less voltage from the previous voltage. At this point, battery is fully charged. And when battery is fully charged at this point, it is disconnect. Then solar charger disconnect battery automatically and it protect battery to damage. This value is less than 10.7 volt, our load will not work. After that, there is a 24 hours. At 24 hours, load will work till 24 hours. So after this, now let me show you how our load works. When we press this button on controller, the load will start working.
So this was overall overview of our project. Solar chargers can be used to charge mobiles, solar fans or batteries. Thank you. That's it.